In this video demonstration, I will present oxygen support for conditional profiling attribute groups, a feature that was added in version 21.0. Conditional processing attributes can be specified using grouped values, and this is intended for situations where an attribute applies to multiple specialized subcategories. To demonstrate this, I'm using a sample project about garage tasks and concepts. For the purposes of profiling my project, I've decided that the default profiling attribute values are not sufficient because some of the tasks require an increased level of skill in two different fields of expertise. For example, I've determined that changing the oil is a task that should be done by a skilled mechanic. And similarly, spray painting should be done by a skilled painter. To achieve my goals, I will use the audience attribute but create a new attribute group called Skilled, with the values of Mechanic and Painter used as the subcategories. The first thing I need to do is to define that attribute group. So, I'll go to the Profiling Conditional Text Preferences page, and I'll edit the Audience attribute, and add my new Skilled group with the Mechanic and Painter values. Now I can use the newly created values to profile my data map and topics. The changing the oil topic is intended for a skilled mechanic audience. And the spray painting topic is intended for a skilled painter audience. Note that the profiled topics now have the proper attribute values displayed in the data maps manager. These new values can also be used for profiling elements inside a topic. For the purposes of filtering content in the published output, I will use a DataVal filtering file. So I'll create a new DataVal file. I want to exclude all content profiled for the skilled attribute group from the output. Now I'll save the DataVal file in a new directory and give it an appropriate name. Now I want to apply the filter on top of my data map to visualize the results, so I need to create a condition set based upon the filter file I just created. This is also done in the Profiling Conditional Text Preferences page. Note that the filter has been applied and the two topics profiled for the skilled audience are now filtered out. The content inside the topic is also filtered. I can further refine the filter. For example, suppose I want to create output intended for a painter audience, so I want to exclude the content that was profiled for the mechanic subcategory, and I also want to mark the content profiled specifically for the painter audience so that it stands out. I can do this by using the flag action and assigning a value for the color and background color. Now, after I refreshed the data maps manager, I can see that only the topic profiled for the mechanic audience is filtered out, and the content of the painter audience is marked with the colors that I specified. The DataVal file I just created can also be used when running a data map completeness check. If I click the action from the Data Maps Manager toolbar, you can see that the applied DataVal file is automatically selected. Now I'll execute the validation operation, and I see that there's a problem in my data map. One of the topics contains a reference that isn't profiled properly because it points to a topic that was filtered out by the DataVal. To solve the issue, I'll profile the reference for the mechanic audience, then I'll run the completeness check again, and the issue is now solved. And this concludes the demonstration. As always, thank you for watching.